Wow. I'm Brett Kingman. This is MI Amplification's Iron Duke version 2. It is a very strong tip of the hat to the classic British amps of the 80s. It begins with an incredibly gorgeous clean channel that can be configured to either a US voicing or a UK voicing. You've got a clean boost channel as well. You've got an overdrive channel. You've got an overdrive boost channel. Each of these channels has various modifications that can be employed within it, giving you about a total of 11 different channels, I guess you could call them. I haven't actually done the math, but it is probably more because this particular version, each of these are built custom ordered as well, I've got to add, but they're not expensive, criminally not expensive. There's another modification switch up here just for the clean channel. You've got a depth frequency control over here. You've got negative feedback control, presence knob, depth knob, high and low power, so you can adjust it from 50 watts down to 25. EL34s, you can throw in whatever power tubes pretty much that you want. On the rear, you will find a fully buffered valve-driven effects loop, and at the moment, I've got the Echosystem engaged in it that I can switch on and off with the foot switch. It completely bypasses it when you switch it on and off. This is a killer amp. So let's have a listen to some of the sounds, and there are so many of them. This is a Music Man Axis. I've chosen to use it because it's got nice, clean pickups, but humbucking as well. So it's a good thing to use for me. So we begin with the clean channel. It has two kind of voicings, a UK voicing, which is what we're hearing at the moment. And a US voicing. Almost a blackface type voicing. Then over here there is actually a third position as well. Slightly fuller US based voicing that Michael, I think, prefers to call his pedal voicing. You know, already we've got three different clean channels. I'm going to leave it in the middle voicing because it's kind of nice and neutral. You've got one volume control for the clean channel over here, but you've also got two bright switches. So if you're using some, you know, darkish humbuckers, you can choose either one of these. Middle position. First position. Second position. Okay, so you've got those three different brightness positions, three different voicing positions, bass, middle, and treble controls, and a volume control. This particular amp has like a volume modification switch up the top here, a three-way. In the middle is just straight, flat-out clean. It's quite loud as compared to the other channels, so Michael's put a mod in there that drops it by about 10 dB. Makes it easier to balance. Over here on the right, we've got a bit more bass. Alright, that's the clean channel. Then, and I'll try and move as quickly as I can, then we've got the clean boost channel. It's got its own gain control. And its own bright control, which adjusts certain frequencies of mids. At the moment, it's in the center or the neutral position. If I go to two, you'll hear it go. And one. So it's adjusting or actually adding, pushing low or high mids respectively on both of those different positions. And you've got plenty of gain. I mean, we're getting into JCM 800 kind of territory now. Unbelievably good crunch sound, but you can use it as a second clean channel if you want to, just back off the gain. You've got a boost modification switch here, which engages two extra stages of clipping. So at the moment it's on the central position, which is kind of dominated by the gain control here. If I want more clipping, I can go to one and then turn it up accordingly because of more compression, so with the louder it needs to be, or two. Okay, again, you can foot switch that just with the boost control. Now, we go to the overdrive channel. Really ballsy. Starts from, you know, this sort of area. Again, it's got a bright control if you want to, you know, add some more tops. Serious. I'm going to leave it in the central position. It also has its own modification switch, so if you want more clipping, you can add more clipping, no worries. And adjust the volume to suit because it'll go into more compression. It's just ridiculously good fun. Let's bump the gain up a little bit. It is nutty. Then, of course, we've got the overdrive boost, which has even more gain. And it has its own modification switch as well, if you want to take it up even into even more gain. Are you sold yet? It's pretty darn good, isn't it? You've got a presence control, you've got depth control, and you've got a great effects loop, and I'm going to engage it at the moment just with the clean, with the overdrive channel at kind of medium filth. Here's the echo system. Man, what an amplifier. I should add, and excuse the lawnmower in the background, the gardeners here, I should add that the speakers are Celestion G12H 30 watters in a Laney 2x12 cabinet. A nice, good medium range, warm-ish speaker. The MI Amplification Iron Duke version 2 is a monster amp. If you love that classic rock sound, you know, right into full-on metal that you can tighten up with all of these different modifications, you've got to get it. You've got to at least try it. See ya.